Have you ever wondered what strategies make Apple, Amazon, and other juggernauts so successful? We read the book Better, Simpler Strategy by Felix Oberholzer-Gee, and we'll share the top insights he uncovered that explain how top companies succeed. You'll learn the value stick framework to raise a company's willingness to pay and lower employees' willingness to sell, how customers and employees contribute to value incentives, how to build value maps to compare against your competitors, and how companies like Amazon, Apple, Ford, and Nike prioritize the right value drivers to grow their business. Real quick, for those who don't know us, we analyze business frameworks and summarize business books to stay on top of the latest business strategies. Felix Oberholzer-Gee is a Swiss Harvard business professor who holds the Andresen Professor of Business Administration title for the school's strategy unit. Professor Oberholzer-Gee received his master's degree and Ph.D. in economics from the University of Zurich. Currently, he teaches competitive strategy focused on leadership development for executives looking to work in media or international business, and has won numerous awards for excellence in teaching. Prior to his academic career, he served as the managing director of Symo Electronics, a Swiss-based process control company. Professor Oberholzer-Gee argues that over the past decades, strategy has become increasingly sophisticated, with only a few companies able to translate strategy into long-term success. Through his research, he created the value-based strategy framework to cut through complexity and clarify how the top companies deepen competitive advantage. He discovered that companies succeed when they create sustained value for customers, employees, and suppliers. To Oberholzer-Gee, it came down to two things. The companies that do the best either increase a customer's willingness to pay or decrease an employee or partner's willingness to sell. Willingness to pay represents the highest value a customer would pay for a company's product or service. If companies improve their product, the willingness to pay will theoretically increase. Willingness to sell represents the perceptions of employees and suppliers. For employees, willingness to sell is the minimum compensation they require to accept a job offer. If companies make work more attractive, the willingness to sell is reduced. If a job is dangerous or exceptionally demanding, the willingness to sell increases. For suppliers, willingness to sell is the lowest price at which they will offer products and services. If companies make it easier for suppliers to produce and ship products, willingness to sell will decline. To visually represent this idea, Oberholzer-Gee created what he calls the value stick framework. The customer's maximum willingness to pay, or WTP, is at the top, followed by the price of a product. Then, its cost, and lastly, the employee and supplier's willingness to sell, or WTS, at the bottom. The difference between willingness to pay and willingness to sell is the value for the customer. The difference between compensation and WTS is employee satisfaction. The difference between price and cost is the value captured by the company. This value stick tool can be used to assess the value your company has created for specific products, specific customer, or specific employee groups. The total value created by a company is the difference between its WTP and WTS. According to Oberholzer-Gee, there are only really two ways to create additional value: increase WTP or WTS. Every significant initiative a company takes must either enhance customer experience and raise willingness to pay, or make it more attractive for vendors or employees to work with you, i.e., lower willingness to sell. Now, a company's ability to capture created value depends on its ability to create differentiated value. The higher and the similarity between your company and your competitors, the more customers will focus on the price, which will create pressure on your company's margins. For instance, many passengers choose which budget airline to fly solely based on ticket prices. Price competition puts pressure on margins and reduces airline companies' ability to capture value. Strategies that lead to exceptional performance use three levers to produce differentiated value. One, they can create customer delight to increase willingness to pay. Two, they can create improved work conditions to decrease employee willingness to sell. Or three, they can improve organizational productivity in ways that are difficult to imitate. Let's explore three great examples of how top companies create differentiated value creation. You can create value through customer delight with a focus on willingness to pay throughout the customer journey and not just to increase sales. For example, when Amazon entered the billion-dollar e-reader market, it was already dominated by Sony's library. Sony had a great product, a first-mover advantage, and a huge marketing budget. Despite these advantages, Amazon won a 62% market share within just 5 years because it offered free 3G internet access. This enabled users to instantly download ebooks, while Sony users had to rely on their computers. The product-centric Sony focused only on a great reading experience that would influence a customer's purchase decision. In contrast, Amazon focused on willingness to pay and improved convenience across the customer journey. Companies with a sustained competitive advantage are able to raise WTP or lower WTS in ways that competitors find hard to replicate. For instance, Apple significantly raises customer willingness to pay for unique products that are radically different from their competitors. Apple's iPhone was a game changer, but between 2009 and 2018, the company faced tough competition from competitors that were much more affordable. Apple originally kept the price of its music and apps low to generate exceptional margins on its devices. But due to intense competition from Android phones, Apple's gross margins on the iPhone fell from an estimated 62% to 38% by 2018. To stay profitable, Apple grew its gross profit from an average app by 4 times in the same period. In a dramatic strategic move, Apple shifted its project pool away from hardware into software. Another way to create value is to reduce the willingness to sell all of your suppliers. Typically, companies want to increase their margins and pay their suppliers less. On the supplier side, suppliers seek to enlarge their surplus. This back and forth bargaining is actually a zero-sum game that creates no value as all the gain comes at the expense of the other party. However, if you manage to decrease the willingness to sell of your suppliers, more value is actually created, and both you and your partners are better for it. For example, after the company faced a major boycott campaign against its suppliers, Nike worked with its contract factories to enable its suppliers to adopt the lean manufacturing model. This not only saved Nike's brand, the resulting productivity advances both lowered Nike's willingness to sell of suppliers and customers, but increased supplier productivity simultaneously. Now, Nike has quality, longer-term partnerships with fewer factories and set an entirely new industry standard for worker well-being and compliance requirements. This focus on value creation is vital to your company's success. While it seems daunting, you should prioritize value creation over your current business model. For example, when Larry Page and Sergey Brin tried to sell their search algorithm for just $1.6 million to the search engine company Excite, the company's CEO refused because a better algorithm would reduce the time spent on the homepage and ultimately lower revenue from advertising. Excite is now dead, and Google is now valued at over $1 trillion. Don't be Excite. Be Google. For more insights from the book, like how to increase willingness to pay with complementary services and partnerships, how to lower willingness to sell of employees with methods other than pay raises, and how to conquer network effects, check out our full book summary in our library. Thanks for watching. And if you enjoyed this video, you can have access to other business frameworks and book summaries. Just check out the link in the description to learn more.